from D Vivid, and I would like to show you something. And think that if you're having the same problem in anti-aging preparation in one of the modules, if someone asks me that, Bhargavi, which is your favorite color, and I say that my favorite color is red, and because red, it is a very nicely color. Is that happening with you? Then this is what the session is for, right? And I hope so that you get a lot of information that can help you upgrade your skills in speaking modules, specifically in your IELTS section. See, basically what I'm going to cover in just the upcoming moments and minutes are the introduction of speaking module. Then we'll be taking on like on what grounds you are being graded in the IELTS for your speaking specifically. And how can we just cross that limit, cross that boundary that we are, you know, facing since long, right? Boundary of 5.5 repeatedly getting or 6 bands, right? So these are the areas that today we are going to cover. Well, I am certified British Council trainer, and here the main motive of coming online with you is I have experienced, I have worked on some of the skills of speaking, how a student or how we can improvise on them. Right, I have experimented and I have seen positive results. So I would like to share those with you so you can gain from them and you can also work on them and get that, you know, limit crossed in just few practices. Because overall, basically what happens is people think that IELTS is a subject, whereas IELTS is IELTS a subject? No. It is a platform that is checking your English, right? It is exactly, if I can say that, it's an exam. It's a form of checking your English. Yes. So English is the main subject that you should work on. You should focus on excelling, right? So let's start. Let's start with the introduction of speaking module of IELTS. Now, speaking module of IELTS, if even you give the pen paper or you are giving the computer base, your speaking comes face to face. Yes. So for those who of you think that, if we give the computer base, the speaking will also come online or, you know, on the computer screen. No. Still, it will be face to face. Right? It is like an interview, one-on-one, right? Yes. And basically, people get scared of speaking module, but there is nothing to get scared of. The people over there who are there to take your interview, they are very normal, they are very natural, they are very encouraging, right? So there is nothing that you can or you should feel, you know, demotivated about yourself when you go there to perform, right? Basically, what I see in students is they don't respect their hard work. They don't respect the English that they have earned by their own efforts. So, guys, first advice that I would like to give you is respect the hard work that you put in to gain your English, gain your language, and respect it, right? It is only when you respect, you will be able to present in front of anyone. Okay, now going into the next step. How much time does it take for my speaking test to complete? It takes approximately 11 to 14 to 15 minutes. So you can say 11 to 15 minutes, right? And these 15 minutes approximately consists of three sections. First is introduction, second goes cue card, and third goes counter questions. Now, what are there in introduction? Introductions are just questions that are based on normal, like about your normal life or just introductory questions regarding you, right? I can give you examples. Tell me something about your hobby. Yes. What are your hobbies? Think. Come on, think up. You might have two hobbies or three hobbies. Okay, if I say the next question, that if you are given a chance to pick any one of them as your profession, which would that be? Think. Yes. So such kind of simple introductory questions will come in this section, which are very simple to answer and should be answered in 2 to 3 sentences. No more than that. Keep it simple. Right? Okay. When we move ahead, we have cue card. Now what are cue cards? Cue card is, there's only one cue card. Yes. Lucky one. Okay. So in the cue card, the total time of cue card is of 3 minutes. 3 minutes? No, Bhargavi, you're wrong. It's only 2 minutes. No, you get one more minute extra wherein you're preparing yourself. Yes, this is the only whole and soul question that allows you for doing your own preparation. This is the question wherein you are supposed to speak, you are expected to speak certain time for either 2 minutes, 1.5 minutes, or maximum 2.5 minutes. Okay, so generally what kind of questions do they cover in this cue card type of question? They again, if for that I can say that the entire speaking is just based on you and you, right? What are your opinions? What do you think about this? What do you think about that? What are your views on this idea, right? So again, the cue card type of questions is again, they are targeting your thoughts, your something that has taken place in your life or would you like to do, right? I should post an example here so that you can understand more precisely. Talk about a building in your city that is your favorite, that you adore the most, right? And you have some questions below that that actually help you structure your ideas in the speaking, in this particular section. They can be what kind of building it is, where it is located, why do you like that, or what is so special about that building, right? So I can just quickly make my notes over there. Yes, I do get a pen and a paper over there wherein I can write my notes. So I'll quickly make my notes in just a few minutes, I mean in just 1 minute, few seconds, and then they take away your question papers. You are left with what? The idea and the notes that you have made. Now you start with your cue card. Okay? And when you are speaking, be normal, be natural. Unless and until your examiner stops you, you shouldn't stop, because I guess that's a bit rude to stop by yourself. Like, and so that is my favorite building. My 2 minutes is completed. Sorry, I can't complete it. No, it is inappropriate, right? Okay, guys. Well, I'm audible to you guys. Hope so. Okay. Moving ahead towards the counter question. Now, counter questions, the type of questions that are there in this particular section are the ones the cue card that was asked to you. These counter questions generally are based on the similar ideas that was reflecting in the cue card. Alright? And here you have to be a little cautious. This is the, I guess, most, you know, marks-taking area, I can say, where you can fetch maximum marks you can. Why is that so? That is so because in this, the type of questions that are hit to you, they are a little tricky, they are a little confusing, and you have to spontaneously answer them. So your language your thought process, your idea side, everything is in function at the same time. So that is why this is a more tricky area of the entire IELTS speaking section, right? Okay guys, let us go now a bit ahead. Fine. Before that, I would like to say one more thing. The number of questions for the introductory as well as the counter question are not fixed. It depends on the interviewer. Say for example, if I am an interviewer and I want to ask you 10 questions or 7 questions or 5 questions, so it is me who can decide that how many questions I need to ask you. But yes, for the cue card wherein you are speaking, the maximum length is just 1, so you don't have to worry much. Okay. And okay, let's go ahead. Fine. I here would like to share something with you guys. You know what? Many people come up and say, how should we practice the speaking? You know, I get scared while I'm doing the speaking, or I feel a little nervous. Do you get any, general knowledge question, scientific questions, or questions related to economics, statistics? No, all the questions that I get in my speaking, every question is based on me, my decision, my point of view. So it is me who is going to decide what I should pick, or I should pick a particular noun or idea on which I am legible. I have legible ideas, I have good ideas to present, right? And guys, this is the only platform where you can represent the English that you're having, okay, to only one person. So go ahead, tell the world that how much English you know. Even if you know English of 5.5 man or 6 bands, guys, it is the platform where you can show people that, see, I know this much. Respect that. Just tell people, just go ahead, instead of getting scared or getting nervous while you are in front of your examiner. It is normal, it is natural to be a little nervous, but grow ahead of that, right? Okay, I think I'm wasting your time much. I should go ahead. Fine. Okay, now let's move to the second part of our session, that is grading, right? Grading, that means on what skills you are being graded, right? You're graded on grammar, you're graded on vocabulary, pronunciation, fluency, right? Okay, so all these four sections that are, again I should come up, grammar, fluency, pronunciation, and what is the fourth one? What is the fourth one? What did I say? Vocabulary. All these four share 25%, right? 25, 25, 25, 25 each, I can say. Hello, Bhargavi. I'm very bad in vocabulary. I have no vocabulary and I'm not able to pull in more vocabulary into my speaking. What do we understand by word vocabulary or lexical resources? I'll give you an example. We have heard this word called delicious, haven't we? Yes. So can I say that, just tell me if I'm right or wrong, okay? Let's say. My mother cooked a delicious cake yesterday evening. Am I right? Yes. But if, and I said that, wow, I learned a nice word, a nice vocabulary called delicious. Now, I can use this word anywhere I want to. Well, let us try, is that so? Can I use it anywhere or everywhere? I just had a delicious tea, a delicious something, is that okay? Can I use that? Or I can say, I had a delicious smelling perfume, deliciously. That means vocabulary or lexical resources means using right word at right place. IELTS never tells you that you should use heavy words, right? No. They encourage you to speak the words. The choice of words should be such that they are appropriate in certain situations only. The situation that you're presenting should have vocabulary or words related to that situation. That is so simple, right? I don't have to use big words. I have to use correct words. Words that actually add perfect meaning to what I want to tell or represent my listener. Right? So next time if someone says that your vocabulary is low, then say that I am using correct word at correct place. Fine, big words I learn later. Okay, fine. Now let's go on each one of them. Fine. Now how to improve your grammar, I shall come a little later on this part. Let us go to the third section of our this session. How to move ahead with the bands that have already scored or the skill that I'm already having, I want to uplift it to a certain band. Now how to do that? Now I'll share with you one exercise that will take care of all the four things, that is grammar, vocabulary, pronunciation, as well as my fluency, right? Okay, so this is the exercise that I tried it on myself, right? I even tried it on my students who were facing problem to speak, right? The ones who are not so comfortable in speaking or they had hesitation of speaking, right? So I just can hope that you are listening to me with proper attention, because now I'm going to tell you my secret of the event. Okay guys, so here, if say for example you are comfortable in understanding English, then good, I'll tell you another thing. But if you are facing a real problem in understanding, or if you are having a problem in speaking, you know, simple sentences, you're not getting ideas or you're not getting words to speak or express, here I say, what will you suggest me? Say for example you know Spanish, okay, and I come to you and I say that, hey guy, please just tell me something that can help me to learn Spanish. You would probably come up and say that, go to KG section. And I say, oh, why KG? Yes. So that is what I'm going to say right now. Just Google out or just go on the YouTube and search for short stories in English for kids. Why? That is so because the short stories are really short. They won't make you or they won't bore you for a longer period of time. The other thing which is very important here is the English that they deliver is very perfect, slow paced. The word, the choice of word that they take, they are quite understandable. The grammar that they use, they are up to the mark, right? So it is the best resource to start learning, right? Now, excuse me, Bhargavi, you told something about listening. Where is the speaking? Yes, here it comes. So whatever story I have heard and I have tried to understand, or in between if I get some words of whose I don't like, the words of which I don't know the meaning, I should Google them up in that very second. Get the meaning, re-listen the sentence, you'll understand what the sentence is saying to you, right? What is this telling? Fine. Now, say for example, my story was a 5 minutes and I completed my entire story What do I have? I have the thinking, I mean the entire understanding of the story. What was the story trying to tell me? Plus few words, I can say vocabulary. Now I know those words. I know how to use those words into my own sentences. Isn't that? Yes, it is. Now, I will speak the entire story by myself. Whatever I've heard, whatever I've understood. Say, for example, you watch a movie, which is a recent movie. I am not so movie watcher kind of person. If I say that you watch a movie, Bahubali, for example. It was of 2 hours or 3 hours of movie. And if I tell you, then can you please tell me the story of Bahubali? Are you going to narrate me the 3 hour story? No, you are just going to brief me out in this 15 minutes. 3 hour story in 15 minutes. Enough for me to understand. Right? You're not delivering the dialogues. Each and every dialogue is not your bola, or is not your bola. No, nothing of such kind. Right? Same thing you're going to do in the story. Right? You're not going to say the conversation between the characters. You are just going to tell me, or you're just going to record. Yes, you heard it right. Record whatever you are speaking, whatever story you are presenting, record it. If I don't know how am I speaking, if I don't know what am I speaking, how I sound, how will I know that how my examiner would like it or not like it, or where am I making mistakes, how am I going? Yes dear, it is very important for me to record my story, whatever I've understood, right? And while I'm recording, while I'm speaking, speak for only 2 minutes, 3 minutes maximum, that's enough, right? The words that I have collected, I should try and inculcate those words into my sentences that I'm talking, right? Record it. Okay, now once I have recorded, I'm done. Hush. What next? Now I should listen. I should take care. Like, what am I speaking? How's my grammar going? What words have I used? Right? Focus firstly on the grammar. Each sentence that I have spoken, right? Is my every sentence grammatically correct? Check it. If not, try to improve it. Write it down. Write down the correct sentence into your book. Right? So listen the entire story. Check it by yourself. Be your own teacher. Be your own invigilator. Right? Once you have done that, redo it once again. Yes. Don't feel that is a boring thing. You have to. Come on, guys. All right. So redo it. Again speak. Again record. And again listen. Have I improved? Yes, I have improved. This is how I will be looking into my grammar, pronunciation, fluency. I haven't yet talked about vocabulary. I've stopped at fluency. Now fluency, some people think that if I speak in very fluid, like very speed, if I speak, you know, hello, how are you? How is your family? How are you doing? Wow, she's so fluent. No, not at all. Fluency means at a speed you're speaking with which a person is able to understand. Right? You are able to take sufficient pauses wherever required. Full stop pause, comma pause. Right? You have to show that. You should be understandable. Right? You're not showing off your language. You are presenting your language. So if I'm presenting something, I'm sure I'm not speaking with a great speed. Why? Because I want you guys to understand what I'm saying. Right? So I am fluent. I'm not taking rapid pauses. I'm not saying and it is good, and my day yesterday was a very hectic one, and it was quite messy. No, not at all. This is not being fluid. This is what, like, lots of speed breakers coming in your way, right? Not healthy speaking, right? Okay. Now, what am I to do with my vocabulary increasing problem? Now, whatever I have spoken, I have definitely used simple words. Say, for example, if I talk about a story of a king. There was a king long, long ago staying in a village. What kind of village was that? Was it a village that was, I can say, it was having good agriculture, it was having a good like natural view, or there was a river passing? What was there? So I should add this. Once I add this, it again increases my effect that I want to provide to my reader or my listener. If I say that yesterday I brought a t-shirt, is it like the sentence is okay? It is quite informative. But what if I add certain information regarding the t-shirt? If I say that it is a blue color t-shirt and it is, the material is cotton, right? So that is how I am adding ideas. I am adding importance to my noun that I'm using. And when I do so, I'm thinking of proper words that I should use to express my idea, right? Okay, say for example, you have completed everything and small words that you have used, you can change those. Say for example, I said, the king used gold coins as a gift when he has to give someone a reward. So the king used gold coins. So can I replace the word use or used? How can I? Now this is a homework for you guys. How can I change that simple word into a better one that can uplift my quality of language that I used? This was just an example, just one word. You can change many simple words, but here you should be very careful because it is English, it is a language, right? If you use a word that doesn't suit the noun or the situation, then you go wrong, right? So check well before you use or inculcate any nice word, nicer looking word into your sentence, right? It should also match the meaning of the sentence that you are willing to show, willing to tell. Okay guys, and one more thing I would like to tell you. If you want to improve a language, say for example, if I tell you to go to South India or to Punjab, you stay there for a month or two, and when you return, don't you think that your accent would have changed? Yes, definitely. How is that? It is due to listening. Language is learned well by listening. So listen to the story, at least do 3 or 4 stories in a day. It is how much you listen, you'll be able to learn. And if you ask me, then it should be done for 2 hours every day. Yes, 2 hours. Guys, you're investing a language in yourself. Why is that 2 hour a long period for you? Yes, it is an investment. Right, when you're going for IELTS, don't go with an intention that I want to hit this band. Go with an intention that I want to show my English. And while you're preparing, you should have an attitude of investing the language in yourself. Right, you're investing it. That is your property that you are trying to master on. Guys, if you really ask me, I will definitely say that master the language before you are going to give the IELTS exam. definitely you'll hit your scores. Whatever the scores you are required, you'll get it. Definitely get it. Okay, guys, and hope to hear from you. Any reviews you want to say, any questions you want to come up, and you can write down the questions, you can post the questions, of which I can or I shall answer those questions once this session gets completed. I'll come back to you and I'll solve the questions that you have posted, and hope that you are satisfied. My session has helped you to learn some of the important or basic methods with which you can upgrade your skill. Speaking is a skill. Speaking is not a subject, it's a skill. A skill is mastered by practicing. Not just you spoke for 2-3 minutes and it is done. No, you need to practice. Practice a lot, right? Okay, guys, bye for now. And whatever questions you have, just post it and I shall answer them in few minutes. Okay, bye. Okay, so I hope I have helped you with that.
Lost the connection.
Can we improve our English by listening English songs? If, say for example, this is a nice one. I've heard this people saying that shall we listen to English movies, or shall we watch English movies and songs to learn English? Do you think that the songs or the movie, they are having proper grammar? They are like, they are made with an intention to provide you entertainment, not the language or the literature knowledge to you. Okay, but if you want to learn English, then the best thing is listening through or learning through stories, English stories. And if you are, you know, a little handy, or if you feel a little confident about English and still you want to hit 7 bands, 7.5 or 8 bands, still I will not advise you to watch the English movies. But the better option is to watch English documentaries, because the documentaries that you'll have, they will possess the technical terms related to that particular subject on which the documentary is shot. Plus the vocabulary, the choice of language, the choice of sentences that they use, right, again are of quality, right, which is very important for your speaking. Right, so okay, I'll post in more answers to the questions that you have come up with, and so like I'm signing off the session and see you guys in few minutes by I'll be answering all the questions into the mailbox. Okay, bye.